The book of Exodus. And if you can park your Bibles at the 25th chapter of Exodus and put your finger in there, and then move with me to Hebrews 9, 23 through 24. In coming to the tent this year, from being awake for about 2.5 months probably out of the country, and I wasn't on vacation, I thought that I was on my way to get healed. But the Lord had a different plan. And the Lord took me away for such a time as this, because there were some things that he wanted to reveal to me. And so I've been preaching now since I was 12.
My God.
And so tonight I have nothing to prove.
Right.
But I have to be sure that I am set properly to say. And I'm
doing this perfect will.
In the book of Hebrews, the 9th chapter, the 23rd to the 24th verse, and it reads as follows: Therefore, it was necessary that the copies of the things in the heavens should be purified with these, but the heavenly things themselves with a better sacrifice than these. For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the true, but into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. So as we look at this passage of scripture, when Pastor asked me to preach the tent, I started asking myself about the purpose for which Pastor Bory, many years ago, put up the gospel tent. And so I recognize that if you don't know the meaning of the thing,
well,
then abuse is the inevitable.
Yeah.
You don't know why you're doing something, then you'll abuse it.
Yes.
Not even knowing that you are abusing.
Yes.
And so in looking at the tabernacle and understanding the fact that tabernacle was a typology of Christ, and that everything in the tabernacle, every part of the tabernacle, represented Christ. You find Jesus Christ in the curtains. You find Jesus Christ in the grave. You find the works of Jesus Christ even in the colors of the curtain.
Yes.
You find Jesus Christ at the brazen altar. You find Jesus Christ at the brazen ladder. And when you look in and you find him at the table of showbread, you find him at the lampstand. You find Jesus Christ at the altar of incense, which is our intercession.
Yes.
But then you move behind the veil, and even in the veil you find Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Yes. When you get behind the veil, there is a small box where you find Jesus Christ. And so, in looking at this box, then we recognize that the entire purpose of this tent, this tabernacle, tabernacle meaning tent meaning tabernacle, was to house this small box.
Yes.
That was its purpose. Its purpose was not, and please let me paraphrase this. The purpose was not for a choir.
Come on.
The purpose was not for a praise team.
Yeah.
I'm not hearing y'all. The purpose was not for instruments, because there were no instruments in the tabernacle. I'm not hearing nobody say nothing. That wasn't the purpose. The purpose wasn't the fact that if we didn't have an organ, then we couldn't praise look around the churches today, we're working too hard. And we're doing too many things because it's a glory now that we got to manufacture. Who am I talking to tonight? But when we recognize the power of the box that was in the tabernacle, we know that it was a glory all by itself. It didn't need to be manufactured. It didn't need nobody to help it. Are you hearing what God is saying? And so if there is no box in our tabernacle, then what are we doing in the house of God? Then what do we call the tent this year? I said, tell somebody you gotta put a demand on the box. I said, it's time to put a demand on the box. So why do you say we have to put a demand on the box? I got to walk through this. Pastor asked me to, he asked me to preach, and he asked me to preach Sunday and Monday. And he said, if you feel like a Tuesday, so you know what, I don't have to be in a hurry. And I don't have to kill the cow in one night. So I gotta take my time and talk about what the problem is. Why is it that Christianity is falling apart? Why is it that people are leaving the house of God? What is the problem? Is there a reason why church has become like a revolving door? People join and then you don't see them anymore. Oh God, I hear the Holy Ghost talking up in here. And somebody said, well, you know what? Well, listen. Maybe it's because the glory of the Lord is not in the temple. Well, if that's the reason why, then we have to ask ourselves, why? What's the neighbor say? What happened to the glory? Y'all didn't stay here a minute. I got about 5 people in here that understand what God is about to say. I said, touch your neighbor, what happened to the glory? Say it again, what happened to the glory? Say it one more time, what happened to the glory? I turn around and ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, as a matter of fact, do you know what the glory is? The glory ain't goosebumps. The glory ain't jumping and shouting. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. The glory is not the piano or the organ. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. That's not the glory. The glory, I can't hear somebody in the outside. In order to find out what the glory is, you got to go back and see what the original intent of God was when he displayed his glory. There was a reason why the glory came. And there was a source from which the glory protruded from.
Jesus.
So he said, what is the glory? What is the glory? Look this up, Pastor. It said one of the words, the Greek word for the word glory. The Greek word for the word glory is apocalypse. Apocalypse. Well, what does that mean? And I know that sounds like some strange off word. But it has to do with the same manifestation as to explain something that looks like an explosion or a brilliant flash. Apocalypse. An explosion and a brilliant flash. So we see that there was an explosion when God got through laying out the tabernacle. The thing that I realized in laying out this tabernacle, and this is why he was going to help us tonight, that the Bible said, and when Moses had completed the construction of the tabernacle according to what God gave him, then the Bible said there was an explosion that the glory of the Lord fell and filled the house. Because every detail of what God said had to be in place was in place. It was a process. You can't just walk in the tent and get the glory. I'm talking to somebody. Because what I'm finding out is that this generation don't want revelation, we want belief. this glory and why this glory come? Who was this glory and why did this glory come? And when the priest walked in, and they had to take the blood of a lamb, and they had to walk that blood. I know some of y'all said, "Well, I already know that," but just humor me, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
But they had to walk that blood through that veil, and they had to place that blood where God said he was going to meet them.
Yeah.
He didn't say, "I was just going to meet you in the praise." But he said, "I'm going to meet you on the mercy seat. I'm going to meet you right there." He said, "What I want you to do, watch this, what I want you to do, so that nobody won't get it twisted as to whether or not I will accept what you are offering me as a real sacrifice, watch this. There's going to be a four-faced beast, and their job is to kill anything that comes. And it's not, oh, you don't hear what I'm saying. He said, their job is to kill everything that's fake. Their job is to kill the fake preacher. Their job is to kill the fake evangelist. I'm not hearing y'all. Their job is to kill the fake praise and worship leader. Who am I talking to? Because I believe that we're in a time now that it's about to release the activity of the cherubim on the mirror, y'all. And I hear the Lord say, "I got to take my glory to a place where man cannot contaminate it." He said, "So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to pull it back until the church gets thirsted for the real glory." I'm not here to talk to me. I'm going to make them have to have church for 2 and 3 hours before they feel. It ain't gonna come easy. It ain't gonna come that easy. Because we in the last hour, it's gonna be the real glory.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can't get nobody to say amen right there. It's gonna be the real glory. It's gonna be the glory where the hollow don't shine down. But you don't care if you don't get no praise. It's gonna be the glory that when you sing, you don't care if nobody see you. word apocalypse. And it says that it's where we get the word apostatic, which has to do with individual existence, meaning he, Jesus, is the exact representation of God.
Yeah.
He is identical to God in his nature. And he is his very essence. This is why Jesus declared, he who has seen me has seen my Father. Anybody hear that today? And so the Lord said that I want my Shekinah. He didn't say my presence. I want it. He said, I want my Shekinah. In other words, I want to dwell in the midst of my people. Y'all ain't saying nothing up here. But the thing about God, he can't touch that. If I don't tell you, he can speak in the atmosphere. But he cannot touch that without a blood sacrifice. And that's why in my shed and the Mahaya, when Adam and Eve sinned against God, they said, I heard God walking in the garden. But the Bible said that God put tunics of skin on them because God had to kill something to keep them killing them. Because the only thing that saves you is the blood.
Hey! she talking about?
God, my God.
I know why you're looking at me like that. Because we're so used to being half done.
So do.
We're so used to being sick and still praising God. We done become accustomed to our condition. But I came in this church tonight to tell you that it's time to be made whole. And God is not going to settle the pieces of you. God wants you whole. And the kind of glory of God wants to touch down in this place.
So what does that mean, sacrifice? What does that mean, the blood? What does that mean? What does that mean? What does that mean? Show yourself. What does that mean, the blood? You gotta ask yourself. What is God talking about?
Jesus.
Wow.
Because there's a difference
than
having church
and
experience.
Glory.
Yes.
Yes. Jesus.
I'm going to say something.
Glory.
If didn't nobody get saved,
come on,
in your service,
come on, now.
You did not experience
you did
not. A touchdown from God. Now, I'm not giving nobody talk back to me when it's okay. Because we can keep pretending all we want to. Y'all ain't saying nothing. That's my church is trying nothing. Ain't nobody about souls no more. Ain't nobody doing no street witnessing no more. Ain't nobody going to heaven. How many of y'all came early and went all out in the park and said, we have an attempt at Bible. Do you want to be saved? Or we can sit in here if you want to with each other. And we can have some good old church. But we're not experiencing that's the kind of glory of God. Who am I talking to? He didn't promise us a presence. He said, I'm going to send my Shekinah.
Wait. Is the Shekinah glory of God?
Yes.
Of what? So listen to Jesus in John 17:5. Now Father, glorify me together with
yourself
with the glory which I had with you before the world was made.
Teach this.
John 17:24 says, now Father, I desire that they also, whom you have given me, be with me where I am, so that they may see my glory, which you have given me before the foundation of the world. And so I can read to you about 30 scriptures that were declared that when the Shekinah glory showed up, standing above the cherubim, it was Jesus Christ himself. I can prove to you in scripture that when Moses went up into the mountain and the glory of God spoke out of the cloud, it was Jesus Christ. Because the Bible said no man has seen God and lived. No man has ever seen God. So every manifestation of God that you see, it is a responsibility of Jesus to reveal what God looks like. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. Where is the church today? Are you kidding me? So if the Shekinah glory is Jesus Christ, then Jesus has no need to show up unless somebody needs to be saved. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me. God, where is the church tonight?
He showed up in a tent like this.
Yes, yes.
Because the whole world was there. And he said, I need some blood.
Yes, yes.
Because I need a replica of what has happened before the foundation of the world was laid.
I
need to see my blood.
Yes.
Because my blood is my identity. See, you can be a type A and get sick, and they put O in you and kill you. It's got to be your blood type. In order for them to say, that's John Bowie. In order for Jesus to say, that's me. Then it has to be the blood of a lamb. Come on, somebody, you're not hearing me. Every typology in the Bible was a representation of the reality that was coming. I'm not hearing y'all talk to me, but I'm going to tell you that Jesus is coming. I'm here to tell you he's about to bring us down. I'm here to tell you heaven is real. And hell is even more real.
took me out. So what he did was, he said, I sit on my throat. This is what I've been experiencing since I've been gone. He said, I sit on my throne myself. So I said, maybe I'm seeing things. He said, I said, it's me. I said, okay, God. He said, my hand is stretched out. And I'm coming for my people. He kept calling me out on the balcony. And every time I would come out on the balcony, every time I would come out on the balcony, the sky would start coming toward me. And I would start backing up till I couldn't back up no more. And he said, I'm talking to you. He said, this is your hour, Pastor. I called you out here because I need to talk to you for real. He said, you've been the people's prophet, but I need you to be my prophet. He said, time is winding up. And I said, okay, God. And so Pastor, he showed me. He said, I'm walking toward my people. I didn't know I was going to preach the tent when this was going on. And then I looked up and saw a moving angel. He said, I'm telling you, I'm moving by my spirit. And I said, okay, God. But watch this, Pastor. Then it got for her. And I said, okay, God, I hear you. He said, no. But when I got on the blood sacrifice, and I got on the Shekinah glory, and I got on while the glory shows up, and I got on the necessity of Jesus dying for us, and the Father offered him up, when I got on the fact that if we don't present our bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, we are waiting in a familiar spirit.
Oh my God.
But he said, I sent it to you. And I said, okay, God, And I said, Lord, I don't want to do this. I said, because how do I know you're talking to me? But Scott came to me another day about 2 weeks later, and he came on top of me, and he said, get your camera. I got my camera and went outside. He said, keep your ears to my lips. And the lips showed up in the atmosphere. And I said, God, what are you saying to me? He said, I said, keep your lips to my ears, because I'm talking to you in this season. I'm prophesying to you in this season. I'm speaking to you what is to come. God, I will go shatter you. When I got through, I said to the Lord my last day, before I came home, I said, God, are you pleased? He said, yes, sir. The sky started coming again. He said, get your camera. He said, I said, I'm pleased. And he showed up himself. I'm here to tell you tonight, I don't have time for it. And if anybody in this church really wants something from God, and you say to yourself, I've been in the same place long enough. I've been just praising God long enough. But Dr. Biden, I need a revelation. I need God to do something different in me. Thank you.
Y'all be saying that. Y'all ain't playing nothing.
pray to you. But if you just believe that God is about to do something in a divine way, the glory of God, somebody in this building, you need to stop praising Him.
That you kind of came because what he said was in the box.
Somebody said, what they got to do with his command, his commandments? Because I found the scripture that says, for I have commanded you to be blessed.
Yeah.
that stands back the bottom.
Glory.
Why are you preaching? I told the devil.
Come on.
I changed my mind. Run down here on this altar. You ain't got to be shame. Now she said you're not making up the call from the saints. Conversations I've been having that ain't helping me please God. And I'm trying to be in a You can be in church cute. You can say you're saved, but you ain't got the fire.
Come on.
How are we in the temple of God with a universal meeting? Both y'all say that completely made up.
Come on.
Catch on fire.
Catch on fire.
And everything about us stay the same from the beginning of the service to the end.
Come on.
But you ain't got the Holy Ghost.
You
got your Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That praise God when you want to praise God.
Right.
That get happy when you get happy.
Right.
And do you know why? Because the Shekinah glory, the Ark of the Covenant, the mercy seat, was about what Jesus did for life. And we done lost our memory about our own salvation. Because we live so rapidly.
Yes.
We're not excited about being saved no more. See, I'm not getting about talking to you without a face of the Lord. Because our hyper crisis at such a low state. So when we say praise the Lord, if it ain't for a car or a house or some money, we act like we don't know how to praise Him. But when I look back over my life and I see the Lord praise me, you ain't got to make me praise God. You ain't got to push me to praise God. I'm just going to be open door to it. I'm just going to be in the door. Keeps me
in the presence of my people. When I see a sacrifice on the altar.
My God.
When I see blood on the
mercy seat. My God.
So you ain't brought nobody to Jesus, and I don't know when.
Come on.
That's why.
See,
you say, but the glory is not on your
life. That's why the glory is on your life.
This is why the believer keeps struggling. We keep praying for a miracle.
Right.
Wait a minute. When provision was provided, and the reason why the bowl of manna stayed in the Ark of the Covenant, to remind you that I'm the divine provision provided. Blood is on this mercy seat.
Blood is on this mercy seat.
I will get this church miracles. It has never seen. Provided. Jesus. Souls is on the altar. See, I can't get the right company. Why is it about the quiet? Because the company just got lost. With just that blood. With just that out of touch. I can remember when I crossed that stage. I wanted everybody to get saved. I witnessed on the bus stop. I witnessed at my school. I witnessed in the doctor's door. You want the face of God back on your life. But I'm ready to tell.
Thank you. have made it under this tent.
Yes, God.
That you would let women and men wander into this tent and don't even know why.
Yes.
I pray tonight that every believer that's standing in this room will become so conscious.
Yes, God.
And they will bring somebody that needs to be saved. We ask you, Lord, don't move your Chicago. We give you our word that when you look and see your blood on the mercy seat, it won't be inactive. When you see it, there will be sacrifices on our altar that prove that we kept your works alive. Namaste.
Come on!
I lost pictures. I lost numbers. And I didn't lose my If you weren't talking, you could put your hand back. If you know what I was talking to you, you might want to listen. Dr. Bonham, I'm going to risk thinking about my life. Thinking about my walk with God. Thinking about where I'm going. Do you not know you can walk all a miracle? You can go join another church. You can leave. You can do whatever you want. But you're taking you with you. And the problem is not what you see. The problem is what you don't have the ability to spiritually change.
Oh, my God.
preaching anymore of cosmetics. I'm not preaching anymore. Oh, my pastor's brain is having a wicked. No, I cannot come. I'm not going nowhere that God is not leading me to go.
I just say what he said. I see all the little things in his place.
You already know what you have. We're asking for something that you ain't got.
Texas, go to AGBM.org and sow your seed, $30, $133. to sow a seed into the big gospel, to sow a seed in your soul. That's what this is all about. Just go to our website, ngpm.org, or you can text it, and you're going to be blessed because God is faithful to his word. Listen, get out to the tent, bring somebody, bring your loved one, your family, your friends, someone who doesn't know you. That's why the tent is here. My father put it up 45 years because it's about souls. Your promise, it's about souls. See the unsaved saved. Our friend, this is the white place. Is that where the answer is? Where is Sarah in the tent? That's where you gotta be. This week, you gotta be in this tent. Watch at Mary Boulevard on the big gospel tent. God bless you.
God, you're calling us to a greater place of holiness and